Hi, my name is Varadarajan. Raja is what I'm known as. I've been in HR for over 35 years after my XLRI graduation. I've been in multiple industries across consulting, financial services, telecom, and the last was in aviation. It's been a wonderful journey, and I've also run businesses, been a co-promoter of a couple of companies as well. So it's been fun, and I'm now practicing on my own. I'm a gig worker. Look, what has happened is that HR is still very traditional in their approach, because they are looking at an employer-employee relationship. They're looking at how I can ensure that equality remains across all employees. They're looking at common platforms for everyone. They're looking at common policies for everyone. Whereas they don't realize that a gig economy worker is not going to be a regular employee for you. He or she is going to help you with a specific project of yours of what you're looking for, and they are not a regular employee. So the struggle for an HR person is to balance between a regular employee and what applies to the regular employee, and to a gig employee where it's not a regular employee. And that is the struggle which happens. You know, I always find, the organizations, everyone in the present world says, I want a gig worker to work for me. But what happens most of the time is, they think that a gig worker is no different from an employee. I'll give an example. I was hearing this example from a friend of mine. They were looking for a communications person, and they are looking for someone who can do a project for 3 months and get out. And they were looking for some good communication skills and employee orientation towards that. Apparently, this person who was shortlisted, when I say shortlisted by the gig help person who's trying to get the gig person in, shortlisted a person and sent to him, excellent person in employee communication, 25 years of experience, 55 years old. The first thing the HR guy apparently told them is, I want a younger person. The problem is that HR is looking at a gig economy as gig person as an employee. So it's not possible for you to look beyond that. Second thing is, if as a gig employee, many times you restrict the information sharing with that person. He is a person and part and parcel of your family. Unless you share the information in the organization, how will you expect the gig person to help you develop systems for you or develop processes for you? So in the part of inclusion, he should be treated as a real employee. He should be part of the family, and don't expect the person to come 9 to 5 unless the project demands you to stay 9 to 5. Ensure that you give a project and get things done. So I think that many companies still give a JD for a gig worker. I don't think it's going to work. What you need to say is that this is a project and this is the deliverable. You tell us, how will you deliver? So is it possible to create a delivery based gig rather than a job description based gig? That is how the person will get involved in the organization, saying, this is a project I want to do and I'm interested in it. If the project doesn't interest, they won't come. By giving a JD, you're restricting the person. So why should the person be a gig employee? He can go and work in another company. He wants to be a gig employee because he wants to do what he or she is interested in, and in a shorter time frame, in the time frame where they have time to balance their personal interests as well. So these are some of the things which the organizations need to do to ensure that they are able to include the gig person in their scheme of things.